Well, this time of year, that transition from summer to fall might be a busier time. It still doesn't mean that we can't make time for ourselves doing something we're interested in. Maybe making time for yourself means sitting down with a good book and reading. I'm joined by the author of the book When You Were Mine, Rebecca Serle, to chat about her newest book, Edge of Falling. Hi, Rebecca. How are you today?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm great, and thank you for coming on the program. So first, what was the inspiration behind this new book, The Edge of Falling?
Well, The Edge of Falling is a story about Kagi Caulfield, a girl who is trying to come to terms with her role in the death of her younger sister. And she's the granddaughter of Holden Caulfield from The Catcher in the Rye. So I would say The Catcher in the Rye had a lot to do with this book. It was a favorite of mine growing up, and also just New York City. I've lived here for about 7 years, and I wanted to set a book here and really make New York a character. So I'd say those two things.
Okay, so now how did you decide that New York was the character you wanted to create? And I mean, I can imagine that was quite an interesting experience, even creating it as the character.
Well, you know, setting is so important to me in my novels. It's really something that I draw huge inspiration from. My first novel, When You Were Mine, was set in sort of a fictional Santa Barbara town. I spent a lot of time in Los Angeles growing up and went to USC and LA. So I felt like I really knew that place well, and I could really set a book there. And now New York, it was time. I mean, it takes me a long time to get to know a place, and I think particularly with a city like New York, it's just so important to understand the way that it moves and the way that it breathes. And so it took me a while, but in the last few years, I finally got to the point where I said, like, okay, I can set a book here and I can do it justice.
Well, what were some surprising things that people will not realize about New York that you end up bringing about? Because typically when we think of New York, we think of the busy, crowded city, everyone walking, everyone in a rush to get where they need to go.
You know, Kagi in the book plays this game that I like to play. I call it the walking game. And it's just, it's for like a leisure afternoon where you don't have anything to do. Sometimes I like to do it on a weekend. And I just walk around. Whenever light changes, I cross the street. And it's like really amazing the neighborhoods and the places that you end up discovering from just playing the simple walking game. I find New York to be a really compassionate city, which I think people don't really know. I never feel, even when I'm alone, and I spend quite a bit of time alone because I am a writer, that it's a very welcoming and warm city. And I always feel like the city is my friend. So I think people would be surprised by how warm it is and how welcoming it is.
And it really is surprising because that city atmosphere has this stereotype that so many people don't think of a warm and welcoming city when they think of really any city, but New York being one of the biggest.
It's true. It's true. What you said earlier, I think, is really on point about it being everyone's in a mad dash. No one has time for anybody else. But no, I mean, I think New Yorkers are some of the kindest, most generous people in the world. So I'm very lucky to be one.
Well, it definitely sounds like this book is worth picking up. What are some other adventures that we can see Kagi going on that we'll be excited to follow her as we read the book?
Oh, there's a lot of really fun New York spots. She goes to Brooklyn. She goes to, like, some cool music clubs there. She goes to the Whitney Museum, which is a favorite of mine in New York. In Italy, which is an awesome market restaurant in Madison Square Garden. So if you spend any time here, and also if you haven't, I think it's a fun tour. I was a huge, huge fan of Gossip Girl, so I definitely wanted to bring the city and its spots into the book.
Okay, so Gossip Girl really played inspiration into the kind of storyline you created.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I did not grow up here, but I, like a lot of people, was fascinated by what it's like to. And when I moved here, Gossip Girl was just starting to become like a really big hit, and I watched the show religiously. I absolutely loved it. And I found myself really intrigued by this sort of Upper East Side world, this world that seems to be so perfect from the outside, but on the inside, there's a lot of drama and pain there as well. So.
And I feel like that's something that a lot of people will be able to relate to as they read the book, because so many of us want to appear put together on the outside, but then we may have that pain or we may have some imperfection that we don't want others to see going on in our lives.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And I think, you know, I think it's really indicative of the teen experience in particular, because I think at least when I was that age, I felt very different. I felt very alienated. I didn't really quite know why. But I definitely felt like something wasn't wrong. And I think that's an experience that most teens can relate to, the feeling of no one really understands me.
Oh, definitely. So is that the thing that you want the readers to get from this? You appeal to more of the teen audience and you want them to understand that people do relate to them, that people understand them and are going through this with them, wanting to help them?
Absolutely. I mean, I always hope that my books provide a friend and some counsel and some hope as well. You know, The Edge of Falling is really a book about grief and about the process of grief and about self-forgiveness. I hope that it offers a hand to people who are experiencing that. Because absolutely, I think that, you know, I think we read to feel less alone. At least I do. And I did. So I hope my book can provide that.
Well, for those who are a fan of your first book, When You Were Mine, how does this compare with that book? Is it something that is on a different page since it's set in a different city, or is it something that easily relates with that book?
You know, I think that I tend to write very emotional stories. So my first book, When You Were Mine, was really about heartbreak. And it was about overcoming first heartbreak and moving on from first love and what that really feels like. My second book is about, like I said, it's about overcoming grief. And so I would say The Edge of Falling is perhaps a little bit darker than When You Were Mine. But at the same time, I think at their heart, they're both stories that have, that take shape around their emotional trajectory. So I think that they're both emotional stories, and I hope that they make people feel.
Well, I hope so, too, because just hearing you describe it, it really does sound like it's a book to get people thinking. It's a book to help them really relate to what's going on in their life.
Yeah. I mean, I would love to contribute to a dialogue. That's really why I write, is for people to read and for people to be touched in whatever way by it, so...
Well, where can people go to pick up a copy of The Edge of Falling and even your other book, When You Were Mine?
Available in bookstores everywhere. Of course, I would encourage everyone to support their local indie bookstore. You know, pop on by and see what you can find there. And if it's not there, please request it.
Awesome. Well, we'll definitely have to do that. And thank you for coming on the program, Rebecca. It's been a pleasure talking with you.
Thanks so much for having me. You have a great day.
You too. That was Rebecca Serle. She happens to be the author of the book When You Are Mine, and now her newest book, Edge of Falling.